everybody, it's Dr. Joe. And Brian, he's going to be my model today because I am going to show you a special test called the biceps load test to test for a labral tear. So let's get started. Disclaimer alert, disclaimer alert. So this test is specifically for a slap tear. And the slap, yeah, I have to do that to him a lot, stands for superior labrum anterior to posterior. And when that happens, the bicep tendon that's connected to the labrum pulls that labrum away and that becomes a tear. That's what I had, and I had surgery for it, so I know what it's all about. But just to let you know, these tests aren't foolproof. So there can be false positives and false negatives. Mine, I actually didn't have a lot of pain with this test when my friend who is a physical therapist did this. So I didn't have a lot of positives for the labral tear, but guess what?
You had one.
I had one. So I'm gonna have Brian lie down and get comfortable. So he's probably gonna prop up his feet, but you want your patient to be super comfortable. So if they put their legs all the way down, that's fine. If they wanna prop them up, that's fine. But you want them to be nice and relaxed so they're not uncomfortable, so you can really make sure that the test is being done correctly. So for the bicep load test, what you wanna do is get them into 90 degrees of abduction, 90 degrees at the elbow. So that kind of puts them into that stop sign position. Now, if someone's having a lot of pain in their shoulder, this might be painful even if they're just in this position. But you want to have their hand in a supinated position. So that means palm up and their thumb is going to be facing them. So I'm just going to have him kind of relax a little bit in this position. And then what I want him to do is pull in this way towards his head. And then I'm just gonna let go and let him smack his head. Just kidding. What you're gonna do is resist him doing that. So he's activating that bicep tendon. So go ahead and pull in towards you. So while he's pulling, I'm resisting. And if he has that pain or that apprehension look, that's usually a positive sign. But just remember, again, that positive sign doesn't necessarily mean a slap tear. It could just be some biceps tendonitis. It could be an impingement. So just take it for what it is and just realize if somebody's doing this and they don't have a shoulder injury, go ahead and go again, Brian. That's not painful, right? So if there's not an injury, it shouldn't be painful. So just use it to narrow down what's going on. Oh, so I slapped Brian away. It's just me now. But that was your biceps load test to test for a slap tear. So one more time, just remember, there's lots of false positives, there's lots of false negatives. So just because it's positive for pain doesn't necessarily mean it's a slap tear. There's lots of other tests you can do for that as well. This is just your tool to narrow everything down. But if you have a positive test and you want some stretches and exercises to hopefully make it feel better, these should help up here by clicking up here. And if you'd like to help support my channel, find out how by clicking on this link here. And don't forget to subscribe by clicking down here. And remember, be safe, don't slap your mama. Have fun, and I hope you feel better soon.